project is the Eiffel Jira plugin. My name is Brandon Rudisell. Next to me is Jaden Young, Brett Connect, and Brendan Curran. Little introduction to our project. Our sponsor is Software Center. More specifically, we're working more closely with Linköping University. From the university, we have Ula Weigler, a professor, and Azim Ahmad, a PhD student. Another contact within the Eiffel community is Eiffel architect Daniel Stahl, who works for Ericsson. Software Center is a group of companies instead of just one. This includes universities as well. Other notable members are Volvo, Saab, Bosch, and Siemens. And their mission statement from their homepage is working together to accelerate novel approaches, the adoption of novel approaches to software engineering. One of those novel approaches to software engineering is the Eiffel framework. Eiffel allows for heterogeneous tools to work with one another in a work environment, meaning that it's from its own documentation, it is a thin layer of glue that connects all these different softwares together, whether it be version control or continuous integration software or management software. Eiffel should be able to handle it and allow them to work together, allowing developers to use whatever they like. Eiffel is licensed under Apache 2.0, meaning it's open source. The problem that we were set out to fix is that Eiffel needed a way to receive Jira events. This is in an effort to expand the amount of compatible management softwares. Our project has, over time, turned into introducing new events to Eiffel as well, and we aim to achieve these.
So our first solution is the use of the Jira Webhook API. The main reason for this is because Jira can be used in two different ways. One way is on a local machine, your own server, and another way is through their cloud-based system. The problem is any plugin created for one generally doesn't work for the other, but the Webhook API is more of a little bit universal, so it works for both. So that's why we chose to use that. This Webhook API sends all of the information to a user-defined URL where we can pick out all of the pieces from this JSON blob that's deposited there, compile our set of instructions, and send it off to Eiffel for its consumption. And this was our schedule from the onset. The software developer just wanted to be able to implement issue tracking softwares, more specifically Jira at this time. During sprint one, we wanted to expand that a little bit and come up a more standardized vocabulary so that implementing other issue tracking softwares was a little easier. Currently, as it stands, we have a prototype plugin working. It has to take care of a couple of components, dealing with a persistence ID, domain objects, validation, and then publishing with Rabbit. In the future, we hope to move a couple of these pieces out so that they're a little more universal, usable by other additional plugins later on, mainly the persistence, the Rabbit publishing, and the validation.
Sorry, I skipped the slide.
Yep. This before or after?
This is your next one, yep.
Okay. In our development process, we ran into a few blockers, a couple of dependencies, mainly the absence of a persistence layer to draw previous information from, gather UUIDs to incorporate into our current events, as well as refining the scope of our project. We are continuing to work with the Eiffel community, identifying issues, adding additional proposals, and planning for the future.
A good deal of what we've done so far. We kind of started out just trying to see how would grabbing events from Jira look like? Like the as it existed, didn't really have a notion of issues of projects as first-class objects. They were kind of a little second-class, often somewhere else, but they didn't have their own canonical representation. So to start off, we didn't start straight away on protocol editions. We just wanted to see what does the code look like, right? Because that's always a fun place to start. So we started off with that prototype, just grabbing things from Jira. And in the course of writing the prototype, we ran into a few different problems. Problems that we solved on an ad hoc basis, but that we, when looking at it, we really realized that this is something that should have one solution out there. That anyone that's writing all these different plugins, they aren't going to want to redo this every time. We got in contact with the original architect of the Eiffel Protocol, Daniel Stahl, who mentioned earlier at Ericsson. And through a long series of conversations, we teased out that there was the software called RemRem, which is short for REST Mailbox for Registered Events. And RemRem is really supposed to be this place, this guy is going to do the heavy lifting for you, right? Like when you want to produce Eiffel events, when things happen, the big benefit of this standardized protocol is that you get to link a bunch of different software together. You get to link all these different languages, quote unquote. And the big point of that is that you're linking back to things that happened before, right? You're linking back to Eiffel events that happened in the past. And when you create new events, you're normally, for the most part, going to have to link back to something. And that then necessitates some sort of persistent store, some sort of memory in the system that you're running in. Now, what we've done for our little prototype right now is just keep it in memory. Remember the our little subset of Eiffel events. What RemRem was supposed to be is a software that really provides sort of a nice interface encapsulating this whole idea of building those events up from older events, right? So ideally we'd be able to say, hey, RemRem, there's this person that I want this issue to be assigned to, and I know this issue has the URI, the JIRA field, issue tracker field, that points to this, but that should be a unique identifier. So RemRem hears that, can you please give me back a totally complete Eiffel event that links back to the original Eiffel event to find that issue? But as it stands, it doesn't exist yet. The other big thing we ran into, really when we were navigating around this prototype, is that we don't know where this fits in. We don't know, I shouldn't say where this fits in, but what should the scope of this plugin be, right? Do we want these things to be thicker and have more responsibilities inside this plugin? Do we want to have the absolute bare minimum amount of responsibility? Just taking that little string, our little events, and delegating as much responsibility out as we can. Through our conversations with Daniel, we recognize that this has actually kind of been a problem for other protocol or other plugin implementations, and that there really is a need for some sort of overarching architecture for an Eiffel system. Because what exists now is just a protocol that says these are what JSON blobs look like. It doesn't say these are the actors in a system, these are their responsibilities. That's something we're going to be working on with Daniel, is getting that implemented. That has been codenamed Eiffel Sepia, the implementation architecture. quick demo of what our plugin looks like now. If we head on over to Jira, setup for a plugin is really pretty quick. The only thing you need to do is add a webhook. Right now we have one configured that's listening on something we predefined. So since that is there, if we want to make a new issue, normal Jira workflow, and let's just assign it to me. By creating this in Jira, since we have that plugin running, we also over here have a, this is RabbitMQ running in the cloud that we've posted to. And we can see if we get all of our messages here, that that's been sent over RabbitMQ to the to an exchange, and we've translated what certain fields look like in Jira. Jira's notion of, you know, what is this an issue? Is it a bug? Is it a feature? All those things into a yet-to-be-standardized iPhone vocabulary. It looked like that one actually didn't want to go, because that wasn't the old one. But if we transition to, let's see if it'll do it, if we transition to in progress. Of course, it always works on my machine, right? Oh, there we go. So now we can see that by doing that in Jira, we also got a separate event that links back to, oh, there it is, this event that links back to the original Eiffel event, not the Jira event. and now the questions that we're looking at answering next. Where are you? There you are. Maybe we go back and talk about these different components. We've been talking kind of about what we believe Eiffel Sepia is going to turn out to be, what we think that architecture is going to end up being from our conversations with Daniel Stahl. And that's going to be having those components, those that persistence layer, validation of those events, out off somewhere else so they can be solved once in a language agnostic way, instead of being implemented again and again and again for every little plugin.
So for issues and risks, one of the risks we ran into was not having a repository set up in a timely manner. So what we did was we started our own little repository on GitHub, and then when we were added into the Eiffel community GitHub, we were able to migrate everything we had one over to the other. An issue we did run into was also having no coding standard set. So what we did was we downloaded the Google Java style guide, and we ended up that, so it was resolved pretty quickly. And then the other issue was, again, not having a repository, which we fixed. For velocity, our project has suffered a few blockers. One of the obvious ones is the time zone difference. If you can see the chart next to me here, it's there are very few business hours that North Dakota and Sweden share. Luckily, everybody's been pretty flexible in their schedule, so we are able to meet once a week with pretty good consistency. And then another way we deal with this is asynchronous communication. So if we have questions, we can email them. We have a Slack group with everybody here and our sponsors in it
and so we can, that's how we communicate with them. And it's actually kind of been a good thing. So with the asynchronous communication with email, we're able to better formulate our thoughts and get a more in-depth and intelligent question put out there, which sometimes isn't as possible with just active communication. And then when they send us their answers back, which is usually about a day later because, again, of the time difference, we're able to respond and think about our response and give a more in-depth response. And then the last one was project dependencies. Kind of slowed us down, as talked about in the previous slide. If we were able to go back, upon reflection, if we were able to go back and do anything again, it would definitely be getting involved with the Eiffel community sooner. So that's getting onto the Google group and talking to the Eiffel architect, Daniel Stahl, about where our plugin fits in with, like, as Jane talked about, scope, and then also the implementation of that plugin. For next steps, we're going to continue communicating with our sponsors, with Daniel Stahl, and interacting with the Eiffel community, so we can continue looking for ways to contribute to that community. And questions?
As you had mentioned, some of what you're dealing with hasn't been standardized around yet. Is there something in the works where here's what we have, community, there's voting on it at some set point, or does that seem largely out of your hands and you have no real idea if that's what get adopted or when that might happen?
I think what we have now, the only thing really keeping it from being integrated in the mainline Apple repository is us opening a pull request on the Eiffel repo and that going through review of different members of the Eiffel community. Through our discussions with Daniel Stahl in particular, but also just on the Open Eiffel Google group, and I think we're pretty confident what we have isn't going to need much more modification and that it's pretty agreeable for what it does.
Daniel's wants and needs versus Ola's, how do they line up?
So from what we can tell right now, what Ola wants is for, hey, Ola is in particular working on a program to visualize Eiffel events. So that instead of seeing this block of JSON, you actually see something nice and pretty. And what the big use case that they see out of integrating issue management in general, but JIRA in particular, is being able to see on this big graph that this is where an issue started. This is the start of the work, and you can follow that trail all the way through these different events, be they source chain or source control commits and different builds and tests being run. Now that being said, it's only Ola's focus is having that integration, just having JIRA events in Eiffel. Daniel's wants are more on the scale of the protocol as a whole. One thing that both Daniel and Ola have noticed with different plugins being implemented around the community is that they kind of get to this point where they see these problems to be solved about looking up those events and essentially what Remember is supposed to be, but they get to that point and then there's a whole bunch of work that would be done once that no one really wants to invest the time to do themselves. So I think what Daniel really would want is for Remrem to arrive at its intended purpose. Besides that, also, I think Daniel's main motivation is community building. That getting people active. actively involved in this community, having that discussion board light up, and really is growing, I feel. Not so much on the issue management front, but just as a community.
I think as we go on, Ola's wants and Daniel's are kind of getting a little bit closer. Our meeting with Ola last week, he explained how he liked how involved we were in the community, and he wanted us to kind of keep asking questions and keep staying involved to keep contributing to the Eiffel community.
So in terms of the visualization side, you know, do they have a timeline for when they'll be able to take the part of the project you've built so far and show, hey, here's the event in JIRA, we've taken the output you've produced, and now it shows up in our program that visualizes all of this?
I don't think there's a definite timeline right now. I think that also circles back on the other common problem between implementations, is that there doesn't exist a common, it's not necessarily a problem, but for every different plugin, you need your own domain object representation of something, right? Because you're only going to be getting in a blob of JSON, you need to make it something usable. And there isn't, for any language as it stands, a standard, this is what those objects look like, right? So they would need to, once the protocol, once the events get integrated into the protocol, they would also then need to implement those as domain objects in their visualization plugin, but then those are just, I mean, they're taken, the setup for consuming them is already the same as what they have. It's just a matter of plugging those, making our producer consume, pointing to their consumer. The interface is already compatible, is, I guess, a very succinct way to say it. It'd just be a matter of implementation.
Thank you.
Yeah.